Welcome to Sirone for the fourth edition of the Power Duathlon Italy. For the first one, we had three athletes at the front, with Mark Widmer from Switzerland, Gabriele Roller from Italy, and Attila Zabo from Ukraine. Now we are 25k into the bike lap, and we had an attack from Stefano Luciani in the downhill from the Colle Brianza. Now on top of the Elo climb, we still see Stefano Luciani that is coming out on top of this climb. Let's see what his lead is. Here comes Mark Widmer from Switzerland. And he should be like, it's now 13 seconds behind after Luciani. And now it's coming, Fausto Dotti. It's coming out of the bend, but it's already a big disadvantage for him. It's like 38 seconds. We'll see if this ex-professional cyclist will be able to get back to the front of the race. Now more back behind, more than 2 minutes. We see. Christian Puricelli from Switzerland, and just behind him Sebastian Retzlaff from Germany. Here we see Zabo, who already lost a lot of time. While we hear that Gabriele Rolla has retired. Meanwhile, we heard that Luciani is pushing very hard, and he has now over 1 minute 40 over Widmer and Dotti, who managed to get back to the Swiss. This is a very impressive move, as the athletes will now go on the second bike lap. You're also hearing that Retzlaff dropped Puricelli and is reducing the gap to Widmer and Dotti. Now I'm expecting the athlete on the left ascent to the Elo climb. Luciani has been caught on the Colle Brianza. Dotti seem to have raced very conservatively. Mighty attack on this last climb. Here we go. Widmer and Dotti are leading the race. While we don't see Luciani, he seemed to be dropped. Now we see Luciani coming out. No, it's not Luciani, it's Stefan Retzlaff. This is amazing. He has closed the gap to the leaders almost. Very impressive. He was almost 3 minutes behind after the run, and now he is with the leaders of the race. It's very impressive, especially because the other are not bad cyclists. Dotti was former professional cyclist with Liquigas, and here we see Luciani almost with no energy left. We will have no chance for the victory today. We have also Puricelli for the second time in Enno, but he's now more than 4.5 minutes behind. It will be very interesting in the final 20k run with Widmer and Dotti fighting for the victory. And let's see if Sebastian Redknapp would have some energy also for the run after this great bike ride. And we see now Szabo also on top of Enno climb. The first one we had like Widmer doing very well, much better than Dotti, but Dotti is very experienced athlete, so he might have saved some energy for this final run. And here we are, the midway of the final run, and we see Mark Widmer making the pace, but right behind him Fausto Dotti, the two are not giving away anything, and as expected, the Sebastian Redknapp was not able to keep the pace of the Swiss and the Italian, and here we see Sebastian Redknapp. Complete different running style. He's losing seconds over seconds, and he's also losing on Christian Puricelli, who's coming from behind. It's now 2 minutes behind Redknapp. We see him now taking a Red Bull for going to this last 10k of one. And on the final lap, still Widmer making the pace, but Dotti not leaving him anything. It will be a very interesting final. Here we see Redknapp losing even more ground, and we see him already looking back. This is a bad sign. There's still some margin, but now we see Christian Puricelli coming from behind, and he's running faster than Redknapp. And here we are at the finish line, and we see it's Mark Widmer. He managed to drop Dotti on the final K, and he's going to win the fourth edition of the Power Duathlon Italy. Great race from the Swiss. And now it's coming Fausto Dotti, and no Italian victory even this time. And now for the third place on the podium, we see Christian Puricelli managed to cork Redknapp and take the third place on the podium. And we see now even Redknapp arrived. That's a great race day here in Sirone with a great winner. And see you next year.